Hey guys, so I'm a YouTube creator, so I don't know why I didn't videotape the first half of this, but I am doing a little bit of a reno. I am just filling in the holes on this wall, and then on this wall, I've also put tape up around. You want to get the green tape, because the green tape doesn't stick as much to the surfaces that you want to protect. So I put it down the stairs all the way down here, it goes all the way around. And all I used was a product that is just like drywall putty, except for it just comes in a little blue container. And I'll go get it in a couple seconds here and go show it to you. But I just want to show you a little bit more. So the tape goes all the way down the stairs where I want to protect. The tape on the top ledge here, as well as the bottom ledge there. And I vacuumed up all the dust from sanding. All you want to do is apply the putty into these little holes here and then sand it with a sanding sponge, which I've also got right here. So you get these sanding sponges anywhere, Home Depot or Home Hardware or anywhere. They come black like this. What you want to do, a good trick, is to actually take the two sponges, and I'll get my... Can you see me? You want to take the two sponges and you want to sand them together so that it makes the surface not as scratchy, else you'll leave big grooves in the drywall. So this is a really good way to get a lot of money back on your damage deposit, because there's times when you come into places and you make damage, and for a couple dollars really, you can do a little reno like this or fixing job like this, fill in all your holes and ensure that you get the majority of your damage deposit back. Because this would cost like $300, $200, $300 for somebody to come in here, fill all the holes, sand it all, then paint it all. So it would take two or three trips for the guy to come back to put putty back on the holes, because sometimes there's air bubbles and stuff like that. So this is a really good way to save your damage deposit and get most of it back, or a majority. Okay, so this is the product here. It's called DAP Crack Shot. So there's lots of products just like this. It just comes in a little container like this. I like to have one for wherever I move around, because then I have a container and it just comes with a little bit of putty inside that you can just use your finger and fill in holes as you go. So I like to do this where whenever I move into a place, and then like we rent. So as we go along, there's gonna be times when you bring stuff in, and like some of the dents were actually here before, but because I was here already, I just filled them in anyways. But there was a couple like this one here when we were moving our bed frame in, it hit the wall. So like made a big huge scratch there. So I always like to do this, and I'm gonna end up painting it. And we got the color match paint to the top, and from an incident that happened earlier on last year, we had a water damage and a guy came in and painted it but left the can. So now I get to use the can. And this is a really relatively cheap. The tape is, I think, $5 or $6, and then the time to do it. And instead of paying somebody $200 to do this, you could get the can of paint for probably $10, have them color match it to whatever you want it to, and then you just get your little roller, and then I'll show you when I'm doing this part. So I just wanted to bring you down here. Obviously I won't do that wall because there's no damage on that wall. It's just on this wall, and then there's just a couple little spots on that wall too. Hey guys, so we are here at the painting stage. I got a few other items, one being this paintbrush from the dollar store for $2, and one being this roller. I've also got the smaller roller, but we already had that. So I went to the Goodwill and I bought this blanket just to cover the areas that we're painting first, and then we'll drag it down and obviously cover this part of the carpet. I just felt like
if we're going to be doing this to save money on our damage deposit, the $2 I spent on the blanket and the $4 I spent on the brushes, I mean, really, it's a no-brainer. So we're just going to start. We're going to use the flathead screwdriver to open up the can. You excited?
First time painting walls.
Give it a little bit of a stir. Hopefully there's enough, else we'll have to get some more made. So it's safe. Put the lid back on it.
Choose your weapon.
I'll use this and we'll go around.
Oh, here's the tiny one.
Let me go around the edge where the tape line is.
Thank you.
been just enough. Just enough. Stay tuned for more content like this and other content. There's some serious content that will be on this page as well, to do with my health, as well as future adventures with my family. As you see, my daughter was doing this with me. She has the idea of building her own YouTube channel as well. Sooner than later, I will drop what the name of that is so that you can join it as well. But I love doing stuff like this, so you'll see lots of stuff like this. If I fix anything on my car, if I fix my bikes or whatever it may be, that's what this channel is going to be about, all the stuff that I love to do. So hope you get value from it all. And again, thank you for watching all my Go Lives that I did on Facebook. It means the world to me. Please smash the like button. Huge love to you all.